On a Saturday, stumbling through the city, feeling drunk from all the car fumes and chain smoking ciggies. We are searching for something, not quite sure what it is. We just roll around in the car park, getting high, and then you kiss me on the cheek and run away down a rusty alleyway. I sit here and look around, you come back and sit down, and we stumble through the city to arrive late at night, getting HJs, getting drunk, trying not to get in fights. So we caught the train to Frio at 1:30 a.m. The kebab shops were all closed, but 7-Eleven sold bread. So we head on down to South Beach for a swim, for a feed. Look in your backpack, find a can of baked beans, and we tear into the tin under the intimacy of stars. And I saw your soul, my darling, heard the sounds of passing cars melt into a sweet cacophony, the ocean in my breath. And in that beautiful silence, you got up and left. So I finished all the bread, and I scraped up the beans, and I walked on my own to my house down the street, and I kicked off my shoes as I hopped in a bed. And I thought about you and the things that you said. Tired, and I woke in a sweat, and I called out your name, and I wonder if you're somewhere doing the same, or am I just a self-deprecating obsessive piece of shit? I apologize for my language, sometimes I'm a bit over the top. In the morning when I get out of bed, I am tired, I'm hungry, I'm all out of breath. Once again, I throw down my bag and I grab out the bread that I bought at the markets where I played today. I was begging for money, for someone to stay for a while and just listen to the words of my songs. Tell me I'm worthwhile, that my existence isn't wrong. Make me feel useful, make me glad to be alive. I guess it's no wonder I sing all the time. So I put the bread in the toaster, and I'll turn on the stove. I'll cook rosemary mushrooms with two garlic cloves. I'll get out a couple plates, a couple of knives and forks too. I was eating alone, but I was cooking for two, just in case that you happened to pop on by. Oh, if I had food ready, perhaps you'd stay a while. But I ate and I ate whilst your meal sat there, getting cold, getting sad. And I sat and I stared and I cleaned up the kitchen, put your plate away, covered it all up in glad wrap, just in case. And you decide to come over later for dessert and red wine. Take your meal home, eat it another time. But I realize you are not coming, I never even invited you. It's probably good you didn't, I probably would have just frighted you. I mean, how could a psychiatrist, get them to pull all the sticks out from my eyes and my ears, all the bugs in my brain. Need to take some time off to feel like myself, yeah.